In one of the online forums, I think it was Perspective, a colleague of mine, a friend who I hold in very high regard, made a comment that writing more than 2 minutes a day is bullshit. I imagine I'm going to be hearing from him after this video. And I think what he's referring to is the adage of John Williams' famous words of, you know, he tries to do 2 great minutes of music a day. One of the posts, Hans Zimmer says he does 1 minute of music a day. John Powell said sometimes he does -2 because he undid 4, you know, minutes that he didn't like. I totally get that. And while I do think that the craft of writing for film, generally speaking, has a bit more time to swim around that way, to be a pro TV composer, there is no chance. Let me save you the suspense. There's no chance. I would say never say never, but there's very little chance you'll be able to be successful being able to only write 2 minutes of music a day. And I'll explain why. The idea of the hardest craft, for me at least, what I've done all of it, games, movies, television shows, blah, blah, blah. For me, the hardest craft is the week to week of a network television show. Why network? ABC, NBC, CBS? Because they air every week and you finish one the week before it airs. On a streaming model, on a show like, say, Vikings, we do them all in advance and then they drop on Netflix all at once so that you can binge watch them. So even in the streaming model, I can be on episode 6 and figure out an idea that would really work better in episode 1 and go back and break into it, or if the client requests that. Network television, you write it and it's on the air next week. That's it. And it comes week after week after week after week relentlessly with no break. You have air dates. It airs every Tuesday at 10 p.m., no matter what. So the craft of writing for network television is what I'm explaining to you guys today, because this is the hardest. If you can do this, you can do anything, for sure. So just on a practical level, let's say, for argument's sake, your show had 25 minutes of music in an hour-long dramatic show, which is about average. Average to low, I'd say. But for the sake of math, if you wanted to work Monday to Friday, you have to do 5 minutes of music a day. You need to leave a day for fixed notes, and usually sometimes a day for spotting. Spotting for me, you may get a half day out of it after the spotting session, but I find myself just getting more organized on spotting days. Spotting is when you sit down with your producers and your directors and you just look at the show together and decide where the music's going to go. So you would write 5 minutes a day, Monday through Friday. You'd probably get fixed notes on Saturday for the mix on Monday and then have a day off or have to spot something like this. What if you have half an hour of music? What if you have 38 minutes of music? What if you have 40 minutes of music? And there are shows that have it. I've done a couple. So now just the simple math is starting to make sense. So this is all great, Trevor. Thanks for the update on how many minutes of music in television, but how the fuck do we get this done? I'm going to show you the way that I did it when I started doing this sort of stuff, because it was the only way I could wrap my head around it. Which is to make a calendar for your day. Some of you are probably going to say, dude, I did not get into music to be an accountant and be forensic about my time. I want to walk in the studio, be creative. Gotcha. But you're not going to be doing network television anytime soon. Just tell me that, which is where all the money is, by the way. So how do you do it? I'm going to make a calendar for you right now in iCal and show you how I would approach it. Okay. So here's a given day, Tuesday. So we're going to get up at 7 a.m. Rise, my child. 7 a.m. And we're going to get into the studio by 8. So this is, you know, emails, you know, whatever your morning, you know, routine is before you get to the studio. Okay? So now what we're going to do is, to choose a different color, we're going to make 2 hour block increments. So this is writing block 1. And it's going to go from 8 to 10. And what you're going to do is, you are going to start at 8, and at the end of those 2 hours, you're going to print your cue. I'll come back to that. Okay, so then we're going to have a little half-hour break, more emails, more, you know, zeroing out your inbox, and we're going to have writing block number two. Then we are going to have some kind of a lunch in here, and more zeroing out your email box, which is basically a job into itself, isn't it? Lunch emails. Now we're going to do writing block three. Emails and bullshit, writing block four. Writing block four. So, if you wrote 1 minute of music in those 2 hours, this is how you would do 4 minutes a day. I remember the first time I worked with a composer, I won't say his name. Well, his name's Ben, but I won't say his last name. And we had to do, I needed help on something. And I said to him, we need to do 4 minutes of music a day. And he looked at me and said, dude, I can't do that. I'd never done that. I'm like, well, let me show you how. This model, oh yeah, and sorry, the last part is, we'll call this review time, review. I'll explain that in a second. If you went in and did 1 minute in 2 hours, had a break, repeat, 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 you have 4 minutes of music a day. What I want you to try, if you want to give this a go, is to do 1 minute in from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. and you set an alarm or, hey Siri, you know, set a timer for 10 a.m. And at 10 a.m., you must print it. I don't care if you didn't finish it. This is the discipline of how I do this, how I got to be able to do this much music at once. So you print it and you're annoyed by it. You said, I wasn't finished or I don't think I got it right. Don't care. That's not, you owe me $100. That's not the rules. Take a break. Next cue. Now, of course, if you're doing a 2 minute cue, you'd split it over 2 hours, but whatever. We get the idea. Write another minute. When the alarm goes off, you print it no matter what. After a while, your internal clock will get a sense of what it feels like to write for 2 hours straight. It's a good stretch for cognitive, you know, engagement without getting too distracted. And it's a good way to break up your day. It feels very linearly. Now, if you could do a minute and a half in 2 hours, it's not bad, right? Then that's 6 minutes of music a day. If you can do a minute, an hour, 2 minutes of music in 2 hours, that's 8 minutes a day. My record is 17 minutes in one day. It was forced upon me. I had no choice, but I you can't not deliver, right? I know lots of composers, lots who are doing 12 minutes a day, 11 minutes a day, especially when you're into either the middle of a season of a show or a second season where you have themes to build on and not everything is completely blank space. 10 minutes a day is really not that unachievable. One of the keys to this is, and this is something that I really need you guys to do if you want to learn how to be a pro television composer, is what I call artificial distractions, which is notifications from Instagram, which is having your phone facing up. You know, I have a special ringtone for my wife. If my wife calls, I'll pick it up because maybe about my kids or something. I ignore my clients. Sorry, guys, it's true. And I'll get back to you in 2 hours. And then I see if anything's gone nuclear or anything's lethal on my email box or my phone. And if I call them back and they say, hey, we've been trying to reach you, I say, sorry, I was writing. You have to carve out this space for yourself that's only for you to go into your zone. No pets, no kids, not the FedEx man, nothing. If you can, this is the home run goal. By carving out 2 hours of a bubble, I even dim the lights separately when I'm writing than right now when I'm doing admin stuff and all the lights are on and sunlight's coming in. That 2 hour bubble is your sacred time. You gotta put it on an altar of like this, no one can fuck with me during these 2 hours. Then you pick your head up and then you deal with life because the FedEx man's gonna come. But you build this muscle memory of being able to work this way. And eventually you kind of go to bed thinking about the 6 minutes you need to do tomorrow. And you kind of go, okay, there's a one big 3 minute cue. Oh, that's another piece of advice. Never do the hardest cue in the TV show on the last day. Do it on like the second day. Just trust me on this one. You go to bed kind of getting that internal rhythm of knowing which cues you're going to do. Okay, well, there's actually about 6.5 minutes in the whole act. Like I'll do act three tomorrow. Things like this. The idea of writing 2 minutes of music a day is great. It's happened a few times in my career, and I relished it. but it's not that common anymore. Even movies, which generally speaking, you know, if you're doing 35 minutes of music in 1 week, so you're doing an hour and 10 minutes in 2 weeks, and you have to do an hour of movie score in 3 months, you know, and this is how some of the great scores are made. You know, I'm sure if Hans is lurking, he'll be chiming in on this, saying that, you know, how long it took him to write the theme for Gladiator, Interstellar. I get it. And when you get a $100 million movie with 3 months of prep time, then that's a different story. I'm talking about you guys who are starting out in your careers. You're going to be doing television, which is a great place to. I love doing television. I love it because once it's done, it's done. when I'm on a movie, I do swim around in my schedule more. I just come in and I feel like I want to do 3 minutes that day, or 2 minutes, or 4 minutes, or I've got a groove. That's different. And I know some of you are looking at this calendar right here and going, dude, that is the antithesis of why I got into music. And I hear you. I feel you. But to go in to the wade into the water with no plan, just I'm going to keep writing until it gets done, you can pull it off, but it's going to catch up with you. The other thing you should know is, and if you asked any pro TV composer, they'll tell you this. He or she will say the same thing. At some point in your career, you're going to get a call from the producer, who's probably one of your best friends at this point, and they're going to say, dude or dudette, I'm going to screw you on this episode. And you're like, okay. And there's no, seriously, you're going to get totally fucked because we're recutting the show. Pardon me. We're recutting the show and we got notes from someone else from the network on this and that. And you usually have 5 days. This week, you're going to have 3 or 2.5. What do you do? Not deliver? There's no music on the air? You know, it's truly failure is not an option, right? So now you start to learn how to be resourceful. You start to use the save as and reshape model, which you get to do after you've been in a show for a year or a second season where not everything is blank space, but you got to get it done. You can music edit your way through it, I guess. You know, there's some of that too. But being prepared for the worst and having that your craft in place to be able to respond like this is the job. And I've always said this, my mantra, and I mean this, I've taught all my assistants this, how big we are on client service, because in my opinion, in my experience, long after the music has faded, what they remember was how it was to work with you. So for example, let's say you have a happy client and they run into another producer at lunch and somehow your name comes up. And the first thing is, oh, Trevor's great. What they meant is not Trevor's music is great. I would hope that they like it. And if it sucked, I'd be fired. But what they're saying is, oh, Trevor's great. Meaning hire him, no problems. He'll always deliver for you. That's what they're really saying. This is the foundation of a career built on with a couple of minor exceptions, like you're being abused or something like that, is always delivering. You know, one of my best friends, I won't say his name because he always gets pissed when I say it. He's a super successful TV show composer, multiple TV shows at once. He's like, haven't missed a deadline yet. Don't plan to. So having a routine for your day like this. Oh, and by the way, when I started, I didn't work 8 to 5. I worked 8 until 2 a.m. So what you're doing is you're taking this exact block system and instead of making it a 2-hour block, you make it a 3-hour block or a 4-hour block. And you work for 12 or 14 hours a day. That's how I started because I couldn't do that much music in 2 hours. Now I have a life. I have children. I don't want to really work past like 7 or 8 o'clock. So this, you know, this built-in thing is something that I've developed as a defense mechanism to make sure I can still have, you know, some work-life balance the best I can. But if this seems too contrived, I totally get it. But if you don't like my plan, that's cool. But you should have a plan in order how to get half an hour of music done in a week. So back to my esteemed colleague, you said writing more than 2 minutes a day is bullshit. I actually kind of understand exactly what he means. And I think if you know, you're not going to write concert music 2 minutes, you know, in 2 hours and fully orchestrated this and that and the other thing. But for the most part, every television show that you watched, the score you liked, this is how they got it done. They had a week. Everybody wants more time. John Williams wants more time. Trust me. You don't have it. They're not going to give it to you. And that's not the job. I found a lot of people who've been moving over from film into television, now that we're in the golden age of television, really struggle with their craft, being able to do it as quickly and as high quality as they did when they had more time. My last video, which is basically a 45-minute wax on about my busing system, it seems unsexy. It seems like super technical. What it does is allows me to work creatively really fast. It sounds fantastic. There's no technical problems. No one loves a cue that was a day late to the stage or has the wrong sample rate or shit like this. All this is about is being efficient and being able to deliver your ideas as quickly and efficiently as possible. So if you aspire to be a pro TV composer or you're coming up in your career, I would highly suggest you give this a try. Take an episode off TV and score it. Give yourself a half an hour of music and get it done in 5 days. You know what I mean? I hope this helps. I know this is kind of an odd subject, but I've been asked this before, and it's a hard thing to answer quickly. How do you manage to get so much music done? By the way, this is before you have two projects going at once, if you're so lucky. So I hope this helps. I want you guys to, you know, think about how to craft your day and really work on the artificial interruptions. Get all those notifications turned off. Your iCal, it'll be there in 2 hours. You know what I mean? Turn your phone upside down. Don't check your texts. You know what I mean? Commit to those 2 hours. You'd be surprised how much you can do when you're really focused and you stay in that zone. I find myself, I'm so used to it now, I can't really write for more than 2 hours at a time without a break. I can't just sit in the chair all day like I used to when I was in my early days. I would get out of the chair for like 12 hours, 14 hours, 16 hours, 18, 20, 24 hours. I just don't have the mental stamina to do that now. I have a complicated life, like I said, families and kids and stuff like that. So this approach works for me. Put your comments below what you think. If you think it's total bullshit, tell me. I don't really mind. But if you do disagree with me, tell me how you would approach it. How would you get 30 minutes of music done in 5 days or 6 days? If you want to try this model on for size, there's two ways to go about it. Give yourself the 2 hour block, like it's on my iCal, and write 30 seconds of music, then move up to a minute, then move up to a minute and a half, and then to 2 minutes, or expand the block to 3 hours or 4 hours and have a longer day until you can find a way to get to the place where you can write six minutes of music a day. Path to the pro composer. All right, there it is. I hope it helps, guys. This wasn't Ask Me Anything from someone, multiple people a while ago, so I didn't credit any particular person for it. But I think that craft, as much as being artistic and being innovative and being original and all that stuff is important, craft doesn't get the love it deserves for being good at it. You're to be a tradesman, to be a craftsman, to be the person who has the skills, has the technology, has the room set up, has the busing system ready to go, that you're ready to respond to the craziness of television. It's bananas. But it's also a ton of fun, and it reaches a lot of people. That's why I love it. So anyway, Ask Me Anything, 6 minutes a day. Give it a try. Put in the comments. Like and subscribe, please. Guys, peace out.